Hello and welcome to the next section in our Rust recipe series. During this section, we are going to be looking at Rust and its foreign function interface and how it can be used by and how it can use other languages. And we are going to be calling C from our Rust code. In order to operate with other languages, many languages pretend to be C. That certainly includes C++ and now Rust and several others too, because C's application binary interface is relatively straightforward. We're going to be relying on GCC, which is the GNU C compiler, and we're going to be relying on make and cmake, all programs which are relatively easy to get hold of on Linux if they didn't already come on your system. You should just be able to do a apt install or whatever your repository mechanisms are to get these. So let's start by making a new directory for D8, that's day 8. And inside this, we're going to have several projects. So we'll start with one for C from R, and we'll create that with cargo. And inside our C from R directory, we're going to create a library called libbadmath, and it's going to do math badly. Let's write a C file inside libbadmath and we'll call it badmath.c. Now, this isn't primarily a how to write C course, so I'm just going to cover some really basic C. So we're going to include the standard io.h, which enables us to use io methods, primarily printf. You put the return type at the beginning. Void means not returning anything. Bad add, so we'll have an add method that takes two floats, v1 and v2. And it will add them together badly. Actually, that shouldn't be void. Let's give it a return type of float. And now we'll print out the two floats that we've been given. So I know how to add, and we'll add this float with this float. In printf, the %f represents floats, and it uses these arguments to match them against the other inputs. And then we will return v1 plus v2 plus something else. Let's go with 10 and make that look like a float. So we now have a C library. I don't really recommend you use this library for anything, but we have one. Now in the same folder, we're also going to create a cmakelists.txt file. This is used by a program called cmake. Now we're just going to set some requirements for our cmake. So cmake minimum required, and then the version must be at least 3.0. The project's name will be libbadmath, and that's a C project. And we're going to add a library to this, and that will be our badmath, and this will be a static library. And the file name is, of course, badmath.c, and this is inside this folder. Finally, the install. We'll set the targets to badmath, and the destination will be here, dot. So that's everything needed to compile the C library so that it knows how to make the outputs we need. Inside our source main.rs file, our normal Rust file, we're going to need to include some extra stuff. So we need a hash, and then we're going to link to, and the library name will be badmath, and its kind will be static. And then we're going to, because we've got this, we need some external C functions that we're bringing into this program. So extern C, and then in squiggly braces, the name of the function we're getting. Bad add, and this will take a v1, which is an f32, which is equivalent to C's float, and v2 will also be the same, and of course its return type is an f32. And when we're just declaring a function that we need to exist, we end with a semicolon. So linguistically, this doesn't look that dissimilar to having a trait that's implemented. Mustn't forget that comma there. And now we have this available. Let's output hello from Rust, and now we need to use this function which we've brought in. Now it's external function, and there's a certain level of unsafety in using foreign language code, because all of the promises and guarantees that Rust is able to make rely on everything being checked by Rust. It can't make these guarantees about other languages, and so we just have to say, well, we're using C code, we trust this C code, and so we put it in unsafe. Unsafe doesn't always mean it's unsafe, it just means we understand that the compiler can't prove it's unsafe. So let res equal unsafe, squiggly braces, and that's bad add of 9 point and 12 point. Note as well that the contents of unsafe are an expression like everything else, so its return can be sent straight outside the unsafe and carried on with as usual. So, print line, squiggly braces, question mark, are you sure that's right? Obviously, this is going to be the wrong answer. It's going to try and add them and add 10 to it as well. We're going to write a build.rs file inside the top level of our folder. Now, in any Rust project, if you have a build.rs file, Rust will assume that it needs to run this before trying to call build. And it will also take the return values from this and use them in the build. So this is a very handy thing to know about anyway. You can use this to convert templates into code or do anything else you feel like doing that doesn't happen in the standard Rust macros. And it's just plain Rust code, so it's very easy to integrate with the rest of your project. So once we've got our build.rs, we need to set the dependencies, the things we're going to use by build.rs, build dependencies, and we're going to require CMake, and the version for this is 0.1.31. So the build dependencies are those required at build time, but are not needed as part of the actual main library. Extern create, and we're going to use CMake. And CMake just provides us some mechanisms for calling CMake and getting things working. So we'll use its config type as well. So inside our main function, let dst equal config new build. That shouldn't be libfoo, but we'll get to that in a sec. So that just actually builds the library using CMake. And then after that, we need to set some behaviors that we need for cargo to take while it's running build. So we send those to standard out print line. So the first line will be cargo rust c dash link dash search equals native equals and then dst display. We also need to say that cargo is going to rust c link lib and that static link will be bad math. Now looking at the structure of our folder, we have build.rs. We have cargo.lock and cargo.toml in the same folder. And then we have libbabmath, which has the babmathc and the cmakelist file. And inside our source folder is main.rs. There's a problem there. I'm calling on libfoo. Actually, that should, of course, be libbabmath. So when we cargo run this, it builds everything. And we go, hello from Rust. 31. Are you sure that's right? I know how to add 9 plus 12. Now, those two seem to be the wrong way round to me. I don't know if it occurs to you that they don't quite fit. That's because we forgot to put a new line in our C printf. So that means it didn't flush, right? At new lines, the thing will print actually out to the screen. So when the program finished, it finally flushed everything that had gone to printf. So we should be able to fix that just by adding a new line. And now when we run it, that's the correct way round.